Very good morning, students. For this lecture and video session, I am going to solve a problem from support reactions. So first, let me just read out the question here. Find the reactions at A and E for the beam subjected to loading as shown in figure. So look at here. So this beam is supported with hinge support as well as a roller support. And on the beam, so the combination of loads are acting. Look at here. This is UEL. This is UDL. And in addition to this, moment, there is a moment is acting. So first, before you start drawing the FPD, this UVL and UDL need to be converted into point load, right? Solution. UVL needs to be converted into PL. So the formula is equal to half W into L, isn't it? So which is 1 by 2 into W is the load intensity of the UL, which is 15, into the length. L is nothing but the span of the UL, which is 3 meter. Right. So which works out to 0.5 into 15 into 3, which is 22.5. So PL is equal to 22.5 unit is kilonewton. And the load acting point equal to 1 by 3 into L, that is from the maximum side. So 1 by 3 into L, which is 3 meter, which is equal to 1 meter from the maximum load, from the maximum side, right? Next, UDL to be converted into PL. So PL is equal to W into L. W is equal to 8. And the length is equal to 3 meter, which is equal to 24 kilonewton. And the load acting point equal to L by 2 for the UDL, right? Length is 3. So 3 by 2, which is 1.5 meter. So now I am going to draw the free body diagram here. So let me just start with A. So the type of support here is the hinge support, which will have two reactions. One is vertical, the other one is horizontal. So let me just start with A. The vertical reaction as VA and the horizontal reaction as HA. Let me just extend the beam right. So here is a point B, and here is C, and here it is D, and here it is E, and here it is F. Got it? So the UEL, which is acting 1 meter from the maximum. So from here is 1 meter, which is acting of magnitude 22.5 kilonewton. 22.5 kilonewton. Got it? And the UDL 24 kilonewton, which is acting 1.5 meter between B and C. So from B to C. So this is where the UDL is acting, that has been converted into point load, that is of 24 kilonewton. And at D, a moment is there of 15 kilonewton meter. And at E, look at here, this is a rocker or the roller support, which will have a vertical reaction. So it can be mentioned as VE. Right. At point F, look at here, a point load which is acting at an angle of 45 degree. So its nearest horizontal can be in this direction, and its vertical, nearest vertical can be in this direction. So this can be mentioned as 25 sine 45, and this can be mentioned as 25 cos 45. Now I am going to mark all the distance. Right. So from the origin to the load, it is 1 meter. And A to B is 3 meters. So A to B is 3 meters. So balance would be of 2 meter. And the UDL, that is the UDL, has been converted into point load, which is acting 1.5 meter from B. So this is 1.5 meter. Then B to C is 1.5. So 3 minus 1.5, which would be 1.5 meter. And C to D is 3 meter. And D to E is 3 meter. E to F is 3 meter. Got it. So now I'm going to apply the equilibrium condition. Applying equilibrium conditions. What are the conditions for 2D? Which is sum of horizontal force equal to 0, sum of vertical force is equal to 0, and sum of moment equal to 0. Right. So let me just resolve the horizontal forces first. 0 equal to, how many horizontal forces are? 1 and 2 horizontal forces are there, right? 0 is equal to, so look at here, this arrow is facing towards the positive x direction, so which will carry the positive sign, let's say. And look at here, this arrow is facing towards the negative direction of x direction, so which will carry the negative sign of 25 cos 45. So when you just substitute the value 25 cos 45, which works out 17.68. So let me just take the HA here. So HA equal to 17.68 kilonewton. Got it. So next, let me just resolve the vertical forces. So sum of vertical forces equal to 0, then 0 equal to, how many vertical forces are there? Look at here, at point A VA, which is acting vertically upwards, so which will carry the positive sign VA, and this 22.5, which is facing downwards, so definitely this is a negative value, negative sign. And this 24, which is facing towards the minus y direction, therefore which is have the negative sign. And since it is in moment, so don't consider this. So wherever you have the newton or kilonewton, that needs to be considered, because we are solving the forces, not the moment, right? So let me just move to VE, which is pointing towards the positive y direction, so VE. And look at here, this 25 sine 45, which is facing towards the negative y direction, so which will carry negative sign of 25 sine 45. So 0 equal to VA plus VE, and let me just calculate this value, minus 22.5 minus 24 and minus 25 sine 45, which works out minus 64.18. Minus 64.18. Okay. So let me just take this minus in the other side. So it becomes VA plus VE equal to 64.18. Let me just consider this as equation number 1. So in order to find the unknowns, we have to consider taking the moment about point A. So moment is nothing but the product of force and its perpendicular distance, isn't it? So as far as the origin is concerned, there is no distance, so the moment for HA and VA becomes 0, isn't it? So summation MA equal to 0, so this can be written as 0 equal to, so and this force of magnitude 22.5, which is acting vertically downwards, so it tends to move the tends to rotate the object in clockwise direction, so which will carry the positive sign. So 22.5 into its perpendicular distance from the origin is 1 meter, isn't it? 1 meter. Let me just move to the next force, which is of 24 kilonewton, which is acting vertically downwards, so it tends to move in in the object in the clockwise direction, so positive 24 into its perpendicular distance from the origin. So A to B is 3 meter and B to this point is 1.5, so 3 plus 4 1.5, which is 4.5, right? Let me just move to D, where which is already in the moment, right? So which is rotates in the anti-clockwise, sorry, in the clockwise moment, so which will have positive value. So directly you just substitute that value here. And at point E, a force which is acting vertically upwards, and it tends to rotate the object in anti-clockwise direction, which will carry minus sign. So VE into its perpendicular distance from the origin. So 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. So 12. And look at this force. This horizontal force doesn't have any perpendicular distance. Therefore, this becomes 0. And this force, vertical force, which tends to rotate the object in clockwise direction, so which will carry positive sign. And the force is 25 sine 45 into its perpendicular distance from the origin, so which is 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3, which is 15. So 0 equal to, let me just sum all the values here, 22.5 plus 24 into 4.5 plus 15 plus 25 sine 45 into 15, which works out 410.66. 410.66 minus 12 VE. So this can be written as, so 12 VE equal to 410.66. Therefore VE is equal to 410.66 divided by 12. So 410.66 divided by 12, which works out 34.22 kilonewton. Got it? Now just substitute this value, V value, on equation number 1. So substitute VE value in equation number 1. So VA plus 34.22 equal to 64.18. So therefore VA equal to 64.18 minus 34.22. 64.18 minus 34.22, which works out 29.96. So VA is equal to 29.96 kilonewton. Right. So at last you'll have to write the result. So result, so the HA value was 17.68 kilonewton and VE value was 34.22 kilonewton and VA equal to 29.96 kilonewton. So when you have such combination of UDL, UEL and the concentrated or point load, first you will have to convert that UEL and UDL into point loads, and the load acting point needs to be found out. Then after finding all such things, that means the point load and its load acting point, then you just even start drawing the FBD. So now you just forget about the this load intensity, because that is in kilonewton per meter. So what you'll have to mention here is the point load which has been arrived. Then you just substitute those values in the FBD, then you just apply the equilibrium condition, and then just find the unknown forces or the reactions. Right. Hope you have all understood how to solve when such kind of problem been asked. Thank you.